So Mitt Romney just recently made a speech at the Virginia Military Institute on foreign policy. How do you assess his comment when he called for a more assertive U.S. role on the international stage?
In a way, I would say he is correct that the United States ought to project itself in a much more assertive manner. And I think when President Obama came to power, in the wake of the wars in Iraq and the continuing war in Afghanistan, he sort of shied away from trying to push and project American military prowess again. This might have sent a signal, not just military power, but America's power as such, including economic, including what America is, would stand for, political and otherwise. Since the United States is unique, and there's really no rival to the United States anywhere for that matter, at least for now, the United States cannot shy away from taking a more assertive role when it's necessary. For example, on the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, it's necessary for the United States to take a much more assertive role. In the crisis of Syria, there's no question the United States, I feel, is making a terrible mistake by not acting directly. And I'm not suggesting sending troops, but at a minimum support a no-fly zone. I think the United States should be more assertive in dealing with, for example, in Afghanistan. What is the policy? What are we going to do? Have we really given up on the Taliban? And we're going to leave the Afghanis to their own devices? We should have known this is not a winnable war. Again, prolonging the agony, and it's not something that the United States should be doing. So Romney is correct when he said we need to be more assertive. However, that does not mean to be more adventurous. We don't need to be more adventurous, but we have to project our power in a positive way when it's necessary, when it's needed, and not be hesitant, because that sends the wrong signal, for example, to Iran and many other places where Americans' involvement, directly or indirectly, matters a great deal.
So now that the two candidates in polls are pretty much tied right now, as close as it's ever been, can you give us your take on each candidate's approach or stated approach to the Middle East? Give us your assessment of how the next president will approach the Middle East in general.
Well, I'm not sure that either of them have established a sort of blueprint as to what they're going to do in connection with the Israeli-Palestinian conflict or in connection with the so-called Arab Spring and the various uprising. But look, the main thing is we have to keep in mind whatever happened in the Middle East impacts on American national interest, not just economic, but certainly national security concern. So the United States cannot remain aloof as to what's going on in the Middle East and need to get involved directly in an effort to solve some of these conflicts in the Middle East. Romney sort of have changed his color, so to speak. Initially said, for example, on the Palestinian issue, let it ride, the Palestinians are not ready to make peace. In his speech, however, he changed his mind in suggesting that a Palestinian state ought to be established based on a two-state solution. Regardless, whether it's Romney or Obama, they need to be directly involved in the process. I think they should push for a two-state solution. They should end the conflict in Afghanistan as soon as possible. They should bring an end to the conflict with Iran with its nuclear program. These are the things that the United States cannot avoid and must continue to play a very direct role.